Welcome to Swatantra Education. In this lecture, we are going to discuss about the keyword static. So let us consider we have a class and the name of the class is student and it has two instance variables. One is name, another one is age. So I am writing string name and int age. So we are saying that name and age are instance variables. That means these variables name and age are tied to an object of the class student, or we can say these variables are tied with or associated with one object of the class student. So for example, we can write another class and assume the name of the class is test, and in the test we can write the main method. So public static void main string yes. So let us create here in the class test two objects of the student class. So we can write student s1 equal to new student and assume pass some values Raju and 20. And here we can write student s2 equal to new student suppose Rani and 25. So let us create the constructor here student then string name int age. This dot name equal to name and this dot age equal to age. So here we have a class student and we are writing one constructor for this class, and we have another class test, and in the test class we are creating two objects, one is s1, another one is s2. So here you can observe the value of name for object s1 is Raju. Similarly, the value of age for object s1 is 20. So here you can observe the value of name for object s2 is Rani, the value of age for object s2 is 25. So for each object s1, s2, s3, s4, like we can create a number of object. So for each object the name and age values are associated with that object. So if we initialize using this construct parameterized constructor, then these name and age values are going to are initialized from through the user, or it is going to take some random values, not random, the default values. So if we change one name, suppose s1's name we change, so let s1 dot name equal to Rocky. So if we write like this, if we change the name of s1, so it is not going to change or affect the name of s2, because this s1 name and s2 name are independent. So if we change the name of s1, it is not going to affect the name of s2, because these are instance variables, or we can say these variables name and age are tied to each object and they are separated, they are stored in separate memory location. Now in some situations it is required to share some variable among all the objects, like suppose for example we can say mark. Suppose we have one variable mark and for all the student the mark is suppose 60. All the students are going to get 60 marks. So instead of creating or instead of making this an, this is an instance variable. So instead of making this an instance variable, we can share this variable mark among all the objects. So how to share this variable mark among all the objects? So for that we can just write a keyword static. So if we write static, that means this variable, or we can say this particular variable mark, is not an instance variable, it is a class variable. That means all the objects of the class student are going to share this variable mark. And if one object is going to change this mark, then it is going to be affect others. So here we can write like this. So if I write system dot out dot println, suppose we write s1 dot mark. So we can access this variable using the object or using the class name. So if we execute this one, so let us check what will be the output. So here you can see, so the output is 60. Okay, suppose now we want to print the value of s2 dot mark. So just write here s2 dot mark, that means the value of mark associated with the object s2. So let us check here. So here it is printing 60 60 60, means this one is for s1 dot mark and this is for s2 dot mark. So here s1 dot mark and s2 dot mark. Now suppose we want to update the value of mark. So here we can write after updation. So if we update like this, s2 dot mark equal to 50. Now we will simply print s2 dot mark, then s1 dot mark. So before updation s1 dot mark is 60, s2 dot mark also 60. Now after updation, that means we have updated s2 dot mark equal to 50, then after updation what will be the output. So here we can see, so after updation it is printing 50 50. That means if we update the mark from 60 to 50, then it is updated for S2 and for S1 also, because this mark is a shared variable, or we can say static variable or class variable, but name and age are not static variable or class variable. So name and age are instance variable. So these name and age are associated or tied with one instance or one object, and mark is a static variable or class variable, or we can say mark is common for all the objects. So that's why if we update the mark 50 here using the object S2, then it is reflected in all the other objects. Okay. So similarly, if we write a method, or before moving that, we can also write here student.mark. So we can assess the instance variable through the class name. Your class is student, so we have written this static variable inside class student, or we can say this mark is a class variable of class student. That's why we can assess this mark in this way, student.mark, or we can assess through an object. So now let us check what will be the output. So it is printing 50-50, that means, so you can assess student.mark or we can assess through an object. Now suppose we want to fix the mark, that is 60, and the updation of the mark is not allowed. That means if we write this statement s2.mark, then it is going to throw an error. So how to do that? So if we want to fix this value of mark to 60 and further updation is not allowed, then we should write the keyword final before this static. That means if we write final, then that value is not allowed to update. So let us check. It is throwing an error because we have written here final and we are trying to update that one to 50. So if we write final, then updation is not allowed. That's why it is going to throw an error, or it is throwing an error. Now generally we represent the constant values using the final. Suppose the pi value, so final static we can write double pi, and in general the general convention is that the pi value is written using this capital pi, or we can say the constant values are written using the capital letters, or we can say uppercase letters. So generally it is a general convention. You can use also lower case letter. No, the compiler is not going to throw any error, but the general convention is that we use all uppercase letters to denote the constants, and we use final for this. That means if we use final, then, or if we use the keyword final, then updation of that variable is not allowed. So I think this one is clear to everyone. Now let us remove this one. So similar to the variables, we can also make some methods as static. Suppose we want to print one method, like, or we want to write one method static void, and the name of the method is my method, and what is the body of the my method? So my method is going to simple print a statement that inside my method. So it is simply going to print inside my method. Okay. So just write this one after the constructor. Okay. So now here we are writing one method, my method, and my method just prints the statement inside my method. So as we are writing static, it is a class method. So we can access this one using the name of the class. So simply we can write this like, what is the class name? Class name is student. So student dot my method, we can simply call this one. We can call the my method using student dot my method. So let us check what will be the output here. So it is printing inside my method. So in addition to this, we can also use one object of the student class to access my method. So for that we can, or to invoke my method. So for that we are writing s1.myMethod. So let us check. No error inside my method. So we can invoke the method, that is static method, using any object of that class, or we can use from the class name, that means no object is required. So if we write static before a method, then that method can be invoked without creating any object. So here we can also remove these two statements or just give comment. So without creating any object in the main method, so here public static void main, and these two are, we have given comment, then student dot my method. That means no object is created for accessing or for invoking the method my method. So now let us check. Okay, so it is showing inside my method. So to invoke the static methods, we can use simply the class name dot method name, or you can create one object and using that object you can invoke the static methods. So the object creation is optional. So that's why we use static in the main method. So why we use static in the main method? Because we can invoke the main method without creating any object. So while we invoke, or when we call this main method, at that time we do not create any object. So before creating any object, we are just invoking the main method. That's why we are writing static here in the main method. So I hope the details about, or the concept of the keyword static, is clear to everyone. So now we will discuss another concept, that is how to pass or how to use objects as parameters. Now just add one more instance variable like boolean status equal to assume, okay, boolean status. So we will initialize later. So status means whether the student is passed or failed. So when it is true, then we can say the student is passed. When the value of status is false, then we can say the student has failed. Now here in the constructor we can write another one, boolean status, and this dot status equal to status. Okay, so this is the class and these are the instance variable name and age student, and this is the constructor. Now we have one method, that is my method. So here in this my method, the parameter list is empty now. So you can consider this list is empty. So we can pass any values, like we can write int data. That means here the parameter list contains one integer value, or we can say this method, my method, is expecting one integer value as the parameter. And when we invoke this method or call this method, we need to pass one argument or one integer argument. So similarly, we can write one double value as parameter, two double value as parameter, int double, anything, any primitive type we can give as parameter. So in addition to the primitive types, we can also pass or we can also write one object as the parameter. So suppose we want to write one object student OB. So here OB is an object of type student. So this method, we can consider my method, is expecting one object of type student as the parameter. And inside the println method, simply we are suppose writing OB dot status. That means it is going to print whether it is true or false. That means as the status is a boolean variable, it can contain either two values, one is true, or it can contain only two values, one is true, another one is false. So if the student has passed, we can say this status value is true, otherwise it is false. Now let us create one object student. So student s1 equal to new student Raju 20, and so assume Raju has passed in the exam. So it is true. Now similarly, we can create another object s2 Rani 25, and assume Rani has failed in the exam. So we can write false here. Now here we call the my method and pass one object as the parameter or as the argument here. So here when we call, this is called as argument, and here in the method definition, this is called as parameter. So here OB is one parameter and S1 is argument. Now similarly, we can write student dot my method, we can pass S2 also. So here as this my method is a static method, we can directly call using the class name. So student dot my method. So now we will execute the program and check what will be the output. Okay, so it is student, so it is a printing mistake, this one student. Boolean, another printing mistake is there. LEAN. Okay, so it is a typing mistake. Okay, so now let us see. So successfully compiled. So it is showing true and false. So true is showing for object S1, because the status for S1 is true, and for S2 it is showing false. So that's why when we call my method and pass S1 object as an argument, so it is printing the status value for S1, that is true. Now when we call this my method and pass s2 as an object. So it is going to print the status value that is associated with object s2. So for object s2, the status is false. That's why it is printing false. So this one results true and this s2 results false. So the output we are getting true and false like this. So I hope this one is clear. So similar to this my method, you can write any method and pass any number of argument, any number of object as the parameters, or varieties of object also you can pass as parameter. Now here you can observe the return type of the my method is void. So if this method is going to return one integer value, so we can write int. If the method is going to return one double value, so we can write double. So if the method is going to return one array of double, we can write double this square bracket. And if the method is going to return one object, then we can write the type of that object. So if I write student here before my method, then it means that my method is going to return one object of type student. So just remove the static here. So you can also write static, no issues. Now we can create one method here and we can create one object inside my method and we are going to return this object. So here for simplicity, just pass the age value as constructor. And we can write this dot name equal to suppose unknown and this dot age equal to age and this dot status equal to true, we can write. So for simplicity we are passing only one value, that is one integer value age in the constructor. Now we can write student my method. So my method is not receiving anything. So only our focus in this example is the return type. So here we can create one object of type student. So we can write student temp equal to new student. Then suppose we can write age plus 10. Then we can write return temp. So here we can observe temp is an object of type student and this my method is going to return this temp. That means my method is going to return one object of type student. That's why we have written student here before my method. So we have written student here before my method in line number 12. Now simply we call this my method here in class test. So age, the constructor is expecting only one integer value, so just pass one integer value. So here you can write 25. Now s2 dot my method. So just write s2 dot my method and we can write here s3 equal to s2 dot my method. What is s3? So here student s3. That means S3 is a reference variable that is going to refer one object of type student. and we are writing s3 equal to s2 dot my method. So we are not creating any object for s3. In this, we are not using new here. That means only we are creating the reference variable s3 that is going to refer one object of type student. And in the next line, we are writing s3 equal to s2 dot my method. So my method is a method, so just give parenthesis. And here the argument list is empty because my method don't have any parameters. Now simply we can print here system.out.println we can just simply write s3 dot age what will be the value of s3 suppose we want to print. So now let us check what will be the output here. So it is showing 35. Why 35? Now because when we call this my method, then the control comes here and here one object is created and in the constructor we are passing age plus 10. So what is the value of this age? This age means the value of the age that has called this method. So who has called this method? So which object has called this method? So s2 has called this method because we are writing s2 dot my method. So the object s2 has called this my method and that's why this age means the value of age that is associated with s2. So what is the value of age that is associated with s2? So it is 25. And this 25 plus 10, so it is 35. Now the value of age associated with temp is 35. And when this method completes its task, then the temp is assigned to S3. So now S3 or now the value of age that is associated with S3 or that S3 is going to refer is 35. That's why while we print S3 dot age, it is going to display 35. So here you can observe we are using my method and this my method is returning temp. So what is temp? Temp is an object of type student. So here our focus is on this concept, that is how to return one object from a method. Similarly, you can return any object of type of any class using this concept. So I hope this is clear to everyone.